Hi, Mark. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
It's our pleasure. I want to first ask you, how do you think disruptive technologies will change the automotive industry?
Well, I think they'll change it in every aspect possible, from the product to the business model to the processes to the materials. It really touches every part of a vehicle, and it touches the way that we buy transportation mobility. It also really attracts users into the marketplace. So if we can now make mobility and transportation more accessible, we have more people that can use it and will choose to use the automobile as opposed to mass transit or any other type of vehicle. You know, we have a significant amount of the population that don't use transportation, particularly older folks older 65, and that new technologies really brings the ability for that group to be able to participate back again.
Well, can we really say that there's a big forthcoming shift in the way the automotive industry works? You know, as far as time goes, I know in your presentation you said it's not really going to be something we see soon, but is it really, you know, coming along as fast as we think it is?
That's a great question, because what we saw maybe even 5 years ago was a really heavy focus on autonomous and how autonomous would change. And we saw some very aggressive time frames from the OEMs.
Yeah.
So, you know, we saw GM, for example, giving a date of 2020 where they would have an autonomous fleet operating in San Francisco. Well, that's not going to happen. But what is happening is a faster adoption of electrification than we probably thought, even in the US. But what we're seeing behind the scenes is no slowdown in the investment.
Yeah.
We're seeing no slowdown in the testing and the validation. In fact, we're seeing an increase in that. And every announcement you see in the press is still showing that behind the scenes, that technology development is still occurring. We always said that the technology would not be on the roads and really visible until the late 2020s, early 2030s, and I see no reason to change that, but I also see no reason to back off from that being the future model, given the economic incentive and the safety incentive that comes with that.
Are consumers ready, in your opinion, you know, for this change that OEMs and the industry is pushing for in autonomous driving and electrification?
That's a great question. I think there's two answers to that. There's the our projections show that technology is adopted at different rates over different types of consumers. So I mentioned there's early adopters of a Honda electric vehicle back in the 90s. They'll adopt a lot of new technologies, but it really doesn't get to mass adoption until folks like you and I think that the technology is safe, the technology is reliable, it's a cost equivalent to the technologies we're using today, and then it becomes mass adopted. But that's a long time frame. I think there's another element to this, which is geographic. So if you've got lots of alternatives, so you live in a big city with lots of public transportation and a network of in the future mobility companies who are operating in that area, it's easier to shift. I live right now in Detroit, where the alternatives are not very available.
You kind of have to have a car.
So I have to have a car at this point in time. But that will change as the investment and the technology is adopted, and we'll see much wider consumer adoption. Are they ready now? Probably not.
How do you expect mobility as a service will change the way the automotive industry works? And will OEMs, for example, offer mobility as a service themselves instead of going through third parties like Uber or Lyft?
I think it'll be both. I think OEMs are certainly setting up to build and operate fleets. And it changes the economics of the industry completely.
Yes.
So instead of buying a vehicle, spending on average $36,000, we're now spending $1, $1.50 per mile. And so the OEMs get paid on a much slower basis. So that trickles through to everybody in the supply chain. Because if the OEMs are not getting paid quickly and they're not selling a lump sum, are they going to be willing to pay a supplier a lump sum? We'll see. And so how that changes the economics of the industry, we're a long way from that, but that's certainly something to consider. I think the other thing to consider is the willingness of OEMs to stay in the manufacturing role. They're already starting to see and to reach out to big tier one suppliers who have a lot of capital and a lot of capabilities to help with engineering, to help with design, to help with manufacturing. So I think we'll see a closer alignment of what the suppliers do that the OEMs do today. So that's, again, another significant change in capabilities.
You were mentioning, you know, how this would change and affect the supply chain. How do you think, oh, you have like a concrete example in the way you think this might change away from the current model we have today?
So the current model today is oftentimes a built-to-print model where the OEMs are asking suppliers to produce a very specific component or specific component set. We think that that's likely to change as the OEMs focus more on putting their investment into the mobility side of the business and asking suppliers to take more of that risk and ultimately reward for the design and different types of components they produce. So I think that has a significant piece. I think the speed of change within the design of the automotive industry has got to increase, and suppliers have to be able to react to that very, very significantly. And I think what they produce will change significantly. If you're, you know, have a history and a reputation for powertrain components, which are for an internal combustion engine, that business is on the decline. You have to be able to make that switch, and you have to be talking about it now, because those changes are occurring in the design houses of OEMs today. In fact, I think VW has already announced they've designed their last internal combustion engine.
Yeah.
So when VW announces that, you as a supplier have to react and figure out what it is you're going to be producing.